Good morning, Central Cabarrus.
Today is Tuesday, October 29th, 2019. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey 10th graders, if you missed the pre-ACT, good news. There's a makeup on November 7th in Mobile Unit 9. See you there!
The second annual STEM bonfire will be held Friday, November 15th from 5 to 8 p.m. Tickets are only $5 and this includes the cost of pizza and s'mores. See Ms. Nolan in room 332 for tickets. You must pre-purchase your tickets by November 13th to attend.
Students who plan to attend or apply for college, the next SAT will be offered here at Central Cabarrus on Saturday, November 2nd. To register for the November SAT, go online at www.collegeboard.org ASAP.
Good morning. This presentation is to provide you with dress code updates and reminders. Throughout the first quarter, Central Cabarrus Administration has worked with staff, parents, and students to review our dress code. Our primary goals with dress code are to ensure safety and consistent expectations for all students in an academic setting. Based on the feedback we received and in conjunction with dress code updates at schools throughout our area, we have made several changes in order to ensure that we have a consistent, common-sense dress code. For shirts, our updated dress code states that undergarments cannot be visible and that all tops must have two straps on the shoulders that are a minimum of 1 inch in width. A point of emphasis moving forward is that tops must cover the midsection and back at all times. Shirts that show the midriff at any point in the day are considered out of dress code. In addition, shirts should not have plunging necklines and the sides of the torso should be covered.
These are just some examples of items that do not meet the requirements of our dress code. These items, however, are acceptable under our dress code and may be worn at school at any time.
For shorts, our updated dress code states that shorts cannot be excessively tight, see-through, or short. Please note that to be within dress code, shorts must be at least mid-thigh in length. Athletic shorts are permitted, granted that they meet the dress code requirements in this section.
These are just some examples of items that do not meet the requirements of our dress code. These items, however, are acceptable under our dress code and may be worn at school at any time.
For pants, our updated dress code states that holes in pants, shorts, and skirts must not be above the mid-thigh, the same length as is permissible for shorts. In addition, the dress code continues to state that pants must be worn at the waist, not revealing undergarments or skin. Leggings may be worn as pants, but cannot be sheer or show undergarments. Pajamas are only permitted on school-sponsored Pajama Spirit Days.
These are just some examples of items that do not meet the requirements of our dress code. These items, however, are acceptable under our dress code and may be worn at school at any time.
For dresses and skirts, our updated dress code policy states that dresses and skirts must be mid-thigh or longer in length, as similarly stated for shorts. In addition, dresses and skirts should not be excessively tight or see-through.
These are just some examples of items that do not meet the requirements of our dress code. These items, however, are acceptable under our dress code and may be worn at school at any time.
Our updated dress code continues to emphasize safety and the ability to identify students and visitors to ensure a safe, secure campus. As a part of these measures, headwear should not be worn inside the building, including ball caps, do-rags, hoods, or other head coverings. The updated dress code allows for scarves and headbands as long as they are no wider than 3 inches. Please continue to remember that bandanas are not permitted to be worn or visible.
These are just some examples of items that do not meet the requirements of our dress code. These items, however, are acceptable under our dress code and may be worn at school at any time.
Our primary goals with dress code are to ensure safety and consistent expectations for all students in an academic setting. If you have any questions about dress code, please do not hesitate to ask an administrator or another adult on campus. Thank you.
Senior tie is on sale now. Please see Miss Small in Route 10, 215 to purchase one. Tie will be hung in the senior section of the cafeteria and returned to you at graduation breakfast.
Seniors, you can now submit your senior quote to Mrs. Collier for the yearbook. Go to Mrs. Collier's webpage and go to yearbook. Then open the link for senior quotes. The deadline is November 1st.
DECA meetings in November include November 5th and 9th. On November 20th, the students will attend a district competition at Cox Mill. Students will leave CCHS at 2:30.
And now, an important update for CAFE members. Our next meeting will be Wednesday, October 30th, during Connections in Mobile Unit 8. We'll begin planning our Black History Month celebration and Diversity Week. Please take a picture of the screen to join the CAFE Remind group to stay up to date with an important information.
GSA members, please take a picture of this screen. These are the meeting dates for the fall semester. Remember to join our Remind group and visit the CCHS GSA website and fill out your contact information. This will keep you updated on important dates, meetings, and links to Time Out Youth events. Take a picture and join when you have cell service.
Are you interested in cheering for 2019-2020 Viking basketball season? Cheer tryouts will be on October 30th, November 1st, and November the 4th, from 2:45 to 3:30 in the Norris Cove. Please see either the JV or Varsity Cheer Athletic websites for more information regarding the required paperwork and waivers before participating.
Women's basketball tryouts will begin October 30th after school. In order to try out, students must have an up-to-date physical and completed the proper paperwork online. You can find the paperwork on the school's athletic website. For those who have turned in the necessary paperwork, we have workouts Monday through Thursday after school. Please see Coach Blaylock if you have any questions.
Do you know who your representatives are?
The SAT word of the day is
complacent, which means to be satisfied and not have a desire to change or improve. Synonyms include satisfied, content, and pleased. Though he had never won any awards or even been published, he was complacent with his life as a poet.
Did you know that the first French fries weren't cooked in France?
Really? Where were they cooked?
They were cooked in Greece!
Thank you for watching Central, and have a great day!